Hello and welcome to this new product developed by the navalarc.com, which helps the user calculate the environment forces, which is the current and the wind forces on a tanker. It is valid for tankers with deadweight range between 16,000 to 500,000 tons. This one is based on the OCIMF Mooring Equipment Guidelines 4th edition. In the Appendix A of these guidelines, the theory and all the graphs and charts for the calculation are provided. The importance of this spreadsheet lies in the fact that once the forces of wind and current are calculated for the given environment, these forces can be further used to carry out some analyses like mooring analysis when the tanker is moored in the sea or to the quayside. Let's take a tour of this sheet. This Excel sheet asks for some inputs of the vessel and of the environment. Based on these inputs, and based on the formulae and charts given in Appendix A of Mooring Equipment Guidelines, this spreadsheet will calculate the outputs, which are the current force and the wind force, and also the yaw moment. The coordinate system is shown in this figure, and some clarifications, assumptions, and limitations of this spreadsheet are also provided below that. Let's go to the next worksheet, which is the inputs of the vessel. It requires some general inputs and the principal particulars of the vessel. It also requires what kind of loading condition, whether it is fully loaded or ballasted, and what is the bow type of the vessel, whether it is conventional or a cylindrical bow type. The user is also required to give the transverse and the longitudinal windage areas of the vessel. Next is the inputs on the environment, in which the user is required to provide the design wind speed and the wind angle, and similarly the design current speed and the current angle. The directions for providing the angles is shown in this diagram below. Another parameter required is the water depth. The water depth to draft ratio is critical in determining the current coefficients. Once the inputs are provided, the spreadsheet can calculate the outputs. The first output is the wind force, which is calculated based on the wind force coefficients provided in the Appendix A of Mooring Equipment Guidelines. The graphs used are shown here, and the corresponding values are also shown. With the longitudinal, lateral, and the wind yaw moment coefficients calculated, the final forces and the moment are calculated in this worksheet. Next is the output on the current forces. In a similar fashion, the current coefficients, longitudinal, lateral, and the wind yaw moment coefficients are calculated from the charts. These charts vary with the loading condition of the tanker, whether it is loaded or ballasted. The final current forces are calculated from the current coefficients. That was about the spreadsheet for environmental forces calculation on a tanker based on OCIMF mooring equipment guidelines. This spreadsheet is useful to provide the inputs for some further analysis like mooring analysis, which requires the current and the wind forces as inputs. To download the spreadsheet, please visit the website thenavalarc.com, and please provide us your valuable feedback. Thank you very much.